Hello, welcome to the building aspect of the game. Now, the village building is not so hard to remember, but there are also certain rules. For example, you can destroy any building you place, but you lose some of the resources. So, if you dismantle an alchemist tent, you lose a lot. If you dismantle, let's say, a diner that is upgraded, you might lose a lot. But if you dismantle a refugee camp, that's not a big problem. Let's just do it right now. 6124. 6124. See? That's a pretty steep decline in resources, so don't do it unless you really, really have to do it. And also, some buildings need to be adjacent to the other ones, so I'll just tell you them right now. The refugee camp needs to be next to the diner, smelter next to the forge. I think the crib needs to be adjacent to the cemetery, the warehouses need to be adjacent to the supply depot. And then once you build the forest, you need to build the lumberjacks near it, and also the other tiles of forest. Also, when you build the river, you don't have a lot of control where it flows, so try to make it as far away from your main camp as possible, because it will flow. And I didn't place this on my own, I just placed the first one, and it flows down. Now let's go over the basic elements of the game. So in the beginning, you'll have these buildings over here: refugee, field kitchen, campfire, herbal, smithy, smelter and farm, and also gymnasium, which is a big power spike. So when you upgrade them, they actually change their names, so you might even forget their names, because hey, where is my field kitchen? Hey, it's over here. So upgrading them, it's a huge power boost, but as I said, don't over farm certain regions, because building something like this gives you a big power boost, right? But also building the warehouse and the supply depots is another big power boost. So is the intel center, so are the other ones. As you can see, to unlock some cards, it will give you some basic HP. At this point, you'll have the ability to craft tools. And as you can see, it's a decent forge. That means it will give you the basic starting gear for all of the classes. Otherwise, if it's level 1, it will only give you the basic gear for the warrior for all classes. Dr. Thoughts, it's very important to upgrade this one, because the potions are kind of like your backup strategy. If you take too much damage, you drink a potion. As you can see, the farm needs a lot of space to have around it, so the farm is actually a bit overly complicated in my opinion. So you have 7 fields. That means if you play a game and if you make 7 loops, you'll get 7 scraps of food or 7 rations. If you build more farms and if you get, let's say, 12 wheat fields, that means if you complete a loop with 12 loops, you'll get 1 food supply. So, in a way, it's very useful. In a way, it's kind of lacking in utility after a certain point. Especially after you read the encyclopedia. As you can see, the food can be dropped by treasury cards, fighting on the battlefields, and also from some enemies. So food will not really be a problem in the future. Okay. But the gymnasium is a big thing, because you will actually unlock traits, which are kind of like the skills in your game, so it's definitely the most important building over here. It will increase your survivability by a lot, and also some of the traits are super powerful, especially the ones on the necromancer. Now let's go over to the second part of the game, or the mid game. Mid game, not meat game. And here, the most important one is the Intel Center, which will unlock the Encyclopedia and also Golden Cards. Like the Ancestral Crypt or the Arsenal. So, another important aspect here is that you need to build a supply depot in a way that it has 3 spots around it. So, destroying the supply depot is very, very bad. Again, it's a lot of resources. So, the warehouses are not really well written in a way. They need to work on the translation. So this will give you 10 supply items. I mean 10 max supply items. So in a way, that's 20 new slots you have to equip items. And as you can see, if you equip a lot of items, basically you change the way you play the game by a huge portion. So the portion regarding your health, regeneration and max HP is vastly improved if you use it like this. As you can see, if you just use a lot of kitchen knives and a lot of food, basically health will not be a problem for you. Some jeweler's lens to find extra gear, so you don't have to craft it. Always have these equipped. And then an alchemy shelf for more potions and some more max HP for each resource gained. So that means if I have 10 resources, I have 30 HP. 30 max HP actually. But only for the whole resources. That means orbs of expansion, food supplies, metamorphosis, orbs of afterlife, and so on. So this is kind of like the biggest thing you need to build after that one. The mud huts, yeah, they help you a bit, but again, they're not the main reason you want to build them. Let's just build one right now. You can see we get two slots for our max items. I'm not sure where it says what they give you. Furniture or food to store. Anyway, the main thing is that they give you two max supply slots, and you can also unlock some of the other slots. As you can see, they have a maximum amount. So we have furniture, and I forgot what they said, food and furniture. So they actually upgrade the slots for a specific item. So we have furniture, tools, food, and jewelry. Let's go ahead and put some other food stuff over here, or some other tools. Why not? Let's make something for materials, because at this point I don't really need much. This point it's all about the strategies and the way you play. Of course you can play a very funny strategy, but that will be a time for another day. Let's actually start using this a lot more because I need more resources. That's basically your mid game. Supply depot so you can craft, but I don't recommend you craft because they are pretty expensive. Then orbs of craft. That's actually a lot, so might as well find them, and if you don't find them, you can craft them then. Watchtowers are not so good. Let's go to the end game. So the end game is very important because you will have, let's say, the bridges and the rivers, which are super important for your battlefield placement. You also have the library, which unlocks the bookery, which the bookery is the main way you farm astral orbs because it gives you access to a lot of mage enemies. The war camp, well, the war camp is meh. The outpost is also pretty, I don't know, they don't influence your game that much anyway, and besides, you don't want to place a lot of buildings that don't offer you, let's say, enemies, don't offer you passive bonuses, or don't give something important, so I stopped using it anyway. Lumberjack works the same way as the farm, so that means it's very complicated to use it, but you can craft furniture, so you have to build one. I don't think I even build one, because that's how important I think it is. Yeah, I didn't build one. Okay, I should build one. Let's actually build one right now with the Alchemist Tent. The Alchemist Tent is the most important building in the game because it allows you to decompose and also compose back resources based on your points. What are those points? Well, alchemy points, of course. So for the lumberjack, I need one more food, right? So let's say you have a lot of these cards, Book of Memories. The Book of Memories is basically useless at this point because I have unlocked all of the lore behind the enemies. Hey, spoiler. So there's nothing left for me to do with the books except decompose them. Shift or control doesn't work on you. Click it, so I guess you just have to manually do it. So you have 1000 hydrogen, because that's how it works. Alchemy works with hydrogen. So that means you can build anything of this, including astral orbs. So that's why farming is not so important in the late game. So we can synthesize 50 points to synthesize 25 points to decompose it. Let's build a lumberjack over here. Yes, here supplies with food. That means you can also craft the furniture at this point, which is not so expensive, but again, those orb of metamorphosis are pretty hard to get. So let's synthesize one. And have a sturdy stool. So as you can see, the basic elements of the game really come down to what's happening in the end game. Some of the buildings definitely lose their utility, like the mud huts. Well, you can also upgrade them so that keeps them alive in the game a little more. The watch towers are not so good because by the time you get them, you don't really need them. They just affect, give you an crossbowman when you're fighting near the campfire. That will support you in battle, but you need to place monsters or strong monsters near the campfire. Other than that, there are no other rules except that this is the end game. So if you want to build a lot more, you'll need a lot more farming, but this is the main way to increase your power, the supply, camp supply menu. Other than that, crafting is a good addition to the game, but currently I feel like it's underdeveloped, so don't worry about it too much. Just unlock the cards you need and you can finish the game. Anyway, see you next time, bye!